a very, very short price favourite, generally 1 to 5.
Thanks, Desi.
Brings the time now to 21 minutes to 9 o'clock. Well, a Conservative MP and former soldier has hit out at paying compensation to former paramilitary members who turned supergrasses to help the security services. Patrick Mercer, who served in Northern Ireland, described them as touts involved in an extremely dirty business. He made his remarks during an interview with me earlier when we were talking about the IRA and INLA, and former Raymond Gilmore, who is now, of course, suing the government after allegedly being abandoned and left destitute by the security services. He was forced to go into hiding some 30 years ago. Well, this is what Patrick Mercer had to say.
I think he was paid for what he did. I think he's also been looked after in later life.
Well, he wouldn't say that.
Well, as I say, this is not a cut and dried case. Many of my colleagues were killed and injured. I'm dealing at the moment with two ex-soldiers who were wounded in Northern Ireland, who similarly feel that their compensation for quite clearly serving Queen and country with a written contract, with a pension and with a regimental cap badge to wear.
Mm-hmm. And many of your colleagues maybe are still alive today because of Raymond Gilmore.
Possibly.
And many of your colleagues maybe are still alive today because of Raymond Gilmore.
Possibly.
Maybe because of Raymond Gilmore. Maybe because of Raymond Gilmore. Maybe because of Raymond Gilmore. And many of your colleagues maybe are still alive today because of Raymond Gilmore.
Possibly. It's very hard to prove, and I don't particularly want to make this precise about Mr. Gilmore, because nothing whatsoever can be proved about what these people did or didn't achieve. That was the nature of the case. I'm afraid risks were taken on all sides, and compensation is not something that sits easily with this unpalatable form of warfare.
Of course, police still use informants here in Northern Ireland, and anybody listening this morning on what you're saying about what ultimately happens to informants, that they just get cast aside and they maybe should expect nothing more than that. It's hardly going to be conducive to anybody wanting to sign up to pass on information, is it?
People have got to be extremely clear about their involvement with paramilitary activity. People have got to be extremely clear about their involvement with paramilitary activity. People have got to be extremely clear about their involvement with paramilitary activity. People have got to be extremely clear about their involvement with paramilitary activity.
It's hardly going to be conducive to anybody wanting to sign up to pass on information, is it?
People have got to be extremely clear about their involvement with paramilitary activity. People have got to be extremely clear about their involvement with paramilitary activity, about the risks they take, and about where their loyalty is like.
But in your view, it was a necessary evil, was it?
It was a highly unpalatable and extremely necessary evil, yes.
And in terms of the redress now for Raymond Gilmore, he plans now to sue MI5, and I know that there is a committee at Westminster which deals with intelligence matters. What's his chances of getting anything, do you think?
There's a committee called the Intelligence and Security Committee, which is perfectly above board and completely visible. There's a committee called the Intelligence and Security Committee, which is perfectly above board and completely visible. I'm afraid I just don't know what this procedure is, and I've looked into it in some detail, but I can't find out very much about what this, whatever shadowy procedure this is, if indeed it exists at all.
Patrick Mercer there talking to us earlier on the programme. Well, let's get the thoughts now of the political editor of the Belfast Telegraph, Liam Clark. Liam, morning to you.
Good morning.
Patrick Mercer was arguing earlier there that he doesn't really see the need for compensation because these people were well paid for the information they supplied at the time. Do you think, is this the type of thinking that exists within military circles, given the fact that he is a former soldier?
Well, there did seem to be a certain amount of contempt from by Patrick Mercer for people who were recruited locally to help the security services and were, you know, promised the earth when they were recruited. I mean, we got to remember Raymond Gilmore was first approached by the army when he was 14 and finally recruited when he was 17. Now, that wouldn't be, he gave them bits and pieces in between. That wouldn't be allowed now. He was promised the earth. He was told he was the equivalent of a policeman. And Mr. Mercer is correct. He did get some help. They tend to, they seem to have been contacted by a number of others now. They seem to get help for two or three years, and then the strings are cut. But you have, in his case, somebody who was plucked out of a community who would have never joined the IRA. And Mr. Mercer was quite wrong to say be careful of paramilitary involvement. He joined the IRA and the INLA at the request of the police. And Mr. Mercer was quite wrong to say he should be careful of paramilitary involvement. He joined the IRA and the INLA at the request of the police. He joined the IRA and the INLA at the request of the police. He joined the IRA and the INLA at the request of the police. At the request of the police. At the request of the police. So this was, he was put in harm's way, he was put in a dangerous situation, then he was put in an area of the UK which he knew nothing about. He was like a fish out of water. He had a second identity which was pretty much paper thin, and he got a certain amount of psychological counselling. Then he was told to go to the National Health Service but not tell the psychiatrist why he was suffering all this stress.
What about the tone of what Patrick Mercer had to say? Because there seemed to be some contempt there about the whole practice of dealing with informants. And he told us earlier, in fact, that that was part of his role when he was in the military. It was quite surprising.
Well, I know that Patrick did work in intelligence, but, I mean, the state kind of needs to make its mind up about this. When it needs these people. It can't get information from within, even organised crime, paramilitary groups, terrorist groups like Al-Qaeda, you can only get information about them with inside sources and this is by surveillance. So, I mean, they recruit these people, they promise them the earth, and they really need to make up their mind whether these people disgust them or whether they're valuable assets.
And of course, it all boils down to honour in Raymond Gilmore's case, because he says promises were made and promises weren't kept. A lot of people listening this morning says there's no such thing as honour when you're dealing with intelligence and when you're dealing with such a murky one.
Well, that's right, but I mean, hopefully the tribunal will examine that. I mean, there is a commitment, and I mean, I would stress he did get help to begin with, but I mean, we just need to examine the extent of the commitment and people who are signing up to do this sort of work, which will bring them into danger of death and change their lives forever, then need to weigh up whether the commitment been given by the state is sufficient.
Mm-hmm. And of course, Patrick Mercer talked about the fact that contracts weren't signed back then, so there is no comeback, if you like, for pension rights and so on.
There are some contracts now, according to the textbooks on policing, anyway, in covert policing, there are sometimes contracts now. I did think there was a certain amount, his soldiers who served and had contracts and so on, that they were somehow entitled to better treatment than somebody who was recruited like this as really a young teenager.
And he's surprised just finally, Liam, at the view now taken by Patrick Mercer, because there will be people out there, of course, within the police and so on, who are still trying to recruit informants, and cases put forward like Patrick Mercer's won't help them in their cause.
I don't think it will, and I mean, we need to look at it soberly. I mean, if we don't really want agents and informants, then that's something we need to make up our mind about, and I think that people who are going into this should go into it with their eyes open and know exactly what the state's going to do for them and what it won't.
Okay, Liam Clark, we'll leave it there, but thank you as always for sharing your thoughts with us this morning. That was the Belfast Telegraph's political editor there, Liam Clark. 81771 is the text number if you have a view.